Australia's all-time leading goal scorer.
Sam, good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Does it continue to surprise you how much the Matildas are now loved by all Australians?
Yeah, I think honestly it is surprising me. I think being out of the country, you kind of forget about the Matildas mania, but it's amazing to be back in Perth, and we didn't get to play a World Cup match here, so it's been amazing to bring the team back here and experience WA.
59,000 people, the sun is shining, it's your hometown. What is that buzz like? Does it get any better?
The crowd was amazing, all the fans that came out, they made it a special day for us, and I think you saw that in the performance from the girls.
So is that your favourite hat-trick then?
yeah, I think it's up there. I mean, playing at Optus, the stadium that, you know, I've been watching footy in for a while now, it was pretty nice.
The World Cup run that the Matildas went on, it changed our lives. How did it change yours?
Yeah, I think it was the most enjoyable month of my footballing career, that's for sure. I think we knew the Women's World Cup would be big, but we could have never imagined it would be as big as it was. And we felt, you know, so much support, and we felt really proud going out there every game with the whole country behind us.
So your role changes so suddenly. What was that like, having to watch from the sidelines?
Yeah, obviously being the competitor I am, it was difficult, but the good thing about my situation is that I had an opportunity to come back, so it was just about focusing on the team, making sure the girls performed, and then making sure every minute I was doing everything to help get back for those later games.
Was there ever a moment when you thought, I might not get on the pitch?
Yeah, probably the moment I did it, to be honest. I had never experienced a calf injury like that before, so, yeah, I was probably pretty worried as it happened.
And I know that you're all about the team, but individual awards as well, you're nominated for another Ballon d'Or. It's the highest individual honour. But it must feel great as well to have other Australians in this group.
Yeah, it's amazing. Anytime an Aussie's nominated for that award, it's an amazing achievement. We're, you know, not one of the powerhouses of, you know, the footballing nation. So the fact that we're out there flying the flag for Australian football is amazing, and I think it's well deserved, to be honest.
So the Australian Financial Review said that you are Australia's most culturally powerful figure. You pipped Margot Robbie. How does that sit with you?
I don't know about that one. I don't know if anyone's come close to Barbie, but I saw that and had a little bit of a laugh. I don't read into too much of that things, but it was pretty funny seeing me next to Margot Robbie. Especially with how, you know, famous she's been at the moment with the whole Barbie thing. I don't think I'm anywhere near Barbie, but female Ken.
Female Ken, I like it. This team are really the driving force of this change for football in this country.
I think it's a massive team effort, but I think you're right. I think the Matildas are, you know, the driving force for so much change, and I think football's at the front of that at the moment with participation, the buzz around the Matildas, the crowds, everything like that, that it just increases visibility for women's sport, women's football, and you get things like this, the grants, all of those things that you need to run an amazing sport and have the top athletes in the world competing.
So great to sit down and talk to you, and best of luck with the qualification for the Olympics.
Thank you.